Vlad Kulikov here, Kulikov Grappling Academy, home of Sambo and Jiu-Jitsu Fusion. Thank you for tuning in. I would like to share a couple thoughts with the Japanese audience. I was born in Soviet Union, Russian Federation in particular, and I was lucky enough that one of the most prestigious Sambo academies in the world, Sambo 70, was literally a couple of blocks away from me, and that's where I started my training, and that's where I received my pedigree and all my almost all of my Sambo accolades. Once I moved to the United States of America, it was hard to come by any Sambo training where I lived. That's why I switched from Sambo and Judo, which is the closest cousin, to submission grappling, or submission wrestling, and Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu. Often people ask me what the difference is, because there is a lot of crossover, right? There are takedowns that are scored, positions on the ground that are scored, and submissions. So all that is good. However, regardless of the crossover, Sambo and Jiu-Jitsu are pretty far set apart. And the reason being that Sambo is like 50-50 martial art, grappling art, 50 on the ground, 50 in standing, where in Jiu-Jitsu only mat work is preferred. Of course, there are takedowns, but sometimes you can bypass them completely. And also, in Sambo, there is very limited time on the ground. Once the action is on the floor, parterre, referee has the discretion to stand you up if there is no commotion going on. And then you can score a pin, and once you secure the submission, given 1 minute to finish, if you don't finish, you stand up. That's why the nature of submissions in Sambo is more of a dynamic entrances, stuff that looks almost accidental. However, it's well rehearsed and prepared, as opposed to Jiu-Jitsu, where submissions are given way more time to prepare and set up. That's the major difference. Often people say that Sambo is like Jiu-Jitsu with leg locks. Again, not entirely correct. Of course, we have leg locks in both arts, but again, the nature of leg locks in Sambo is different. It's very fast. And my philosophy on leg locks, I know that in Jiu-Jitsu, until recently, leg locks were kind of frowned upon or whatnot, and not so much in Sambo. So I don't consider myself a leg lock specialist. It just happens so that I've been doing it for a little bit longer, and there's a little bit more of allowance in Sambo as far as ripping and different positions, okay? So I'm not a leg locker, I like them, but I will take anything. To me, the king of submissions is strangulation, right? People can tolerate broken legs, people can fight with broken arms, but nobody can continue after they've been strangled and rendered unconscious. Another thing that happened in the United States, I got lucky enough to become friends with Jake McKee, Budo Jake, a gentleman who runs Budo Videos, and he gave me a great opportunity to present my fusion of Sambo and Jiu-Jitsu. That's exactly what I did. My first set that we shot in 2013 covered three topics: punogi, takedowns, leg locks, and miscellaneous work. I'm very proud of those DVDs, a lot of thought was put. Highly recommend them, and anything done by Jake, great company. And another one I shot for the Gi about Georgian grip. Georgian grip is a particular way of grabbing somebody's belt, moving and scoring on their opponents. And Jake and I, we shot two DVDs, one on offensive and one for defensive maneuvers for Georgian pickup. What can I say to Japanese audience? You guys are awesome. You are the birthplace of Karate, Do, Jiu-Jitsu and Judo. I absolutely love Japanese culture. When I went to Japan in 2018 to compete, I was blown away by the hospitality and politeness of Japanese people. And most particularly in the airport, okay? Once you flew in airport all over, you know, the Western world, and then you experienced Tokyo airport, it's like a Disneyland and a fairy tale. I absolutely loved it, and I've been planning to come over there ever since. So, wink, wink. If you guys want a good seminar for Sambo or Sambo and Jiu-Jitsu Fusion, do hit me up. I travel all over the nation and different countries with seminars. Guys, good luck on the mat. Just do what you do, keep training, and I hope I'll see you on the mat sooner or later. Georgian grip is very indigenous to Sambo, Georgian wrestling, Chidaoba, that's where it came from, Sambo and then Judo. Mostly it's gonna be throws, obviously. But the grip is still applicable a great deal in other areas. It looks like I put Yoshi in a virtual takanda position, which is true. However, he did not get there by himself. I set him up. My first pull is usually the strongest, and I feel opposition, and I'll pull him a little bit more just to keep selling him in the direction that I want to go. And as soon as I feel his weight on his leg, I'm going to move a little launch. Imagine that you're pulling a big rock on a rubber band, and the rubber band gives. Until the tension is expired, and then it goes fine. Step in.